write down the Faraday's law. Faraday's law of induction. Faraday has conducted a lot of experiment and he found out a law. Based on this law only, entire chapter is based. Write down the statement, Faraday's law of induction. The magnitude of the induced EMF. The magnitude of induced EMF in a circuit. What is a circuit? Or it is? It is a loop that contains electrical instruments in it. Resistance, batteries.
So magnitude of induced?
Magnitude of induced EMF in a circuit is equal to magnitude of induced EMF in a circuit is equal to the rate of change of magnetic flux through the circuit. Rate of change of magnetic flux through the circuit. So what does this law gives you? It gives you what? Magnitude of EMF. Magnitude. It doesn't tell you which direction the current will flow. It won't. Fine. For that there is a separate law. So the magnitude of induced EMF is the rate of change of magnetic flux d phi b by dt. Write this down. This negative sign is coming because of Lenz's law that we'll discuss right now. First write down this. This is the negative sign that signifies that the induced EMF will be such, the induced EMF will be such that it will oppose. The induced EMF will be such that it will oppose the cause of creating that EMF. Who is creating EMF? Change in flux. So what it will try to oppose? Change in flux. It will not oppose flux. It will oppose change in flux. Fine. And if suppose there are n turns, the same formula can become n d phi by dt. Every turn there will be a flux associated with it. Now tell me one simple this thing. Suppose you have a loop like this. Okay. You have a magnetic field that is coming out. Okay. This magnetic field is increasing with time. Magnitude is increasing. Which direction the current should flow? Direction of current. Magnetic field is increasing. If flux changing? Flux is changing. So there will be EMF. And if there is EMF, there will be current. And that current should oppose the cause of it. Now tell me. Every time I ask something, this guy is like, okay, ये क्या है? You don't need that. You just need right hand curl rule for everything in magnetism. Everything.
So, but would this work? It takes in the opposite of this would be the direction.
Many things will work, but this is like simplest of them. The cause is increase in the flux, which direction? This direction. The cause is increase in flux in this direction. So the current should do what? Decrease the flux in this direction. So because of the current, magnetic field should be into the board. Getting it? So it will be clockwise. Current will be clockwise. doubt? Any doubt? Should we proceed? Now draw another loop. There is this magnetic field B into the board that is decreasing. Find the direction of current. You can see that easy tell me which direction the current will be?
Clockwise.
See, what is the cause? Magnetic field decreasing in into the board. So what the induced current will try to do? It will try to increase the magnetic field into the board. So it will be clockwise. Now magnetic field is constant. Magnetic field is constant throughout. You have compressed the loop into this shape. Which direction the current will be?
Clockwise.
Batao bhai. Which direction? Magnetic field is into the board. Going in. See, the flux is decreasing in which direction? Into the board. The flux is decreasing because area is decreasing. So it will be clockwise. Decreasing into the board. So it will increase into the board. So clockwise. So now I suppose you are experts in finding the direction of current and you can move forward. This one. When, see, what is flux? Flux is magnetic field into area. Area is decreasing. So flux is decreasing. Which flux decreasing? Into the board the flux is decreasing. So induced current will try to increase the flux because the cause is what? Decrease in flux. Write down a numerical. I am directly taking right now from your NCERT, and if you do the homework then we can go to the mains level also, because it cannot be done without you practicing the basic level of questions yourself first. Write down, a square loop of side 10 cm, the square loop of side 10 cm has a resistance of 0.5 ohm is placed vertically in east-west plane. Okay. Magnetic field of 0.1 Tesla is set up across the plane in northeast direction. Fine. The magnetic field is decreased to zero in 0.7 seconds. B1, B2 becomes zero steadily in 0.7 seconds. Steadily means what? Rate of change of magnetic field is same as average rate of change of magnetic field. Find out the induced EMF and current in the loop. How much is the EMF and how much is the current? Once you get EMF, EMF divided by resistance is the current. Right? Abhay, anyone? Draw the diagram properly. Visualize it. 5 ही नहीं पूछा है?
नहीं
का 5. 5 ही क्यों पूछा है? मेरे को चाहिए EMF and current. 10 to 3 or 10 to minus 3?
Minus 3.
Yes. 1 millivolt. All of you getting it? 1 millivolt. Get the current also quickly. Kya Kevin? Peterson? Aayega? Then you give it to Ankit sir. No, 2 into 10 to minus 3. Fine, look at here now. This is north direction. This is east. This is of course west. And that is south. Where is the top and bottom? Top is this, bottom is into the board. This is horizontal actually, like this. Getting it? So, kya tha isme? Square loop is placed vertically in east-west plane.
Don't talk.
East-west plane is a square, like this. Fine. And magnetic field is in northeast direction. So magnetic field is like this. This is B. Fine. The area vector in which direction? This is the area vector perpendicular to the surface. Getting it? What is the angle B is making with the area vector? 45 degrees. How you find out the area between two vectors? You connect them tail to tail. Fine, so this is the angle. Okay. So flux is what? See, this entire surface has constant area. Vector direction is also constant. Fine, magnetic field is anyway constant. So the flux is B into A into cos theta. This is case number 2. Right? So the flux is B into area into cos of 45 degrees. Fine. B kitna hai bhai? B is 0.1, area is 0.1 into 0.1, meters you have to convert. This into 1 by root 2, this is initial flux. Final flux is what? 0. How much time it has taken? 0.7 seconds. Fine. 1 by root 2 is 0.7.
0.707.
So 1 point root 2 is also 0.7. So all these things you should remember. You should also remember root 3 by 2 is what? So it actually helps. So 1 by root 2 is also 0.7. So if you find out change in flux is the initial flux itself. Fine. That initial flux divided by 0.7 is a change in flux. Change in flux divided by time is 0.1 into 0.1 into 0.1 into 1 by root 2 divided by 0.7. So 0.7 and 1 by root 2 gone. So this is 10 to the power minus 3 volts. And current will be this divided by 0.5